Hello friends, here I am with my new video on famous trilogies. Basically have been asked, frequently asked in UGC NET, and there are so many chances that they'll be asked in future in UGC NET as well. I have taken three writers, Sino Casey, Paul Auster and Margaret Drebber, right? So the first trilogy is that have been discussed by me is a Dublin trilogy by Sino Casey. And you can see here on screen The Shadow of a Gunman, published in 1923, Juno and the Peacock, 1924, The Plough and the Stars, 1926, right? The Dublin trilogy by Sino Casey. So we will talk about the first one, The Shadow of a Gunman. It is a The Shadow of a Gunman is a 1923 tragicomedy play, right? It's a play. So this trilogy covers three plays by Sino Casey, and the first play, The Shadow of a Gunman, was published in 1923. It was set during the Irish War of Independence. Okay, so it centers on the mistaken identity of a building tenant who is thought to be an IRA assassin. It is the first in OKC's Dublin trilogy, the other two being Juno and the Peacock, 1924, and The Plough and the Stars, 1926. So guys, you need to remember that they all have been published before First World War, and you can also say before the first economic recession, which happened in the year 1930. So they all happened before that, the first one being in 1923, the second one in 1924, and the third one in 1926. So now we move on to the next play of that trilogy, Dublin trilogy by Paul Auster. So Juno and the Peacock is the next play in the sequence, which was published in the year 1924. It is highly regarded and often performed in Ireland, and we all know that Paul Auster was an Irish author. It was first staged at the Abbey Theatre in Dublin, right? Dublin is also in Ireland, in 1924. So you have to remember that it was first staged at Abbey Theatre in Dublin in 1924. It is set in the working class tenements of Dublin in the early 1920s during the Irish Civil War period. It is second of his Dublin trilogy, the other two being, I've already told you, The Shadow of a Gunman, the first one, Juno and the Peacock, the second one, The Plough and the Stars, the third one. See, I'm repeating things so that when you listen to this video, it helps you to remember things for long. So The Plough and the Stars, this is the third play in the Dublin trilogy by Sino Casey. Oh, sorry, I mentioned it, Paul Auster. I'm so sorry, I take my words back. It has been by Sino Casey. The Plough and the Stars is a four-act play by the Irish writer Sino Casey that was first performed on February 8, 1926 at the Abbey Theatre. It is set in Dublin and addresses the 1916 Easter Rising. Right, it was first performed on February 18, 1926 at the Abbey Theatre. It is set in Dublin and addresses the 1916 Easter Rising. So you have to remember, the most important thing to be remembered about The Plough and the Stars is the Easter Rising of 1916. The play's title references the starry plough flag, which was used by the Irish Citizen Army. It is the third play of OKC's well-known Dublin trilogy, the other two being The Shadow of a Gunman, 1923, and Juno and the Peacock, 1924. Now let's move on. Now we move on to another very famous author of ours, which I have covered. Paul Auster's The New York Trilogy. Friends, this is very, very important from that point of view. And introduction, let's talk about it. The New York Trilogy is a series of novels by American writer Paul Auster. So you have to remember that Sino Casey was an Irish writer, whereas Paul Auster is an American writer, right? So originally published sequentially as City of Glass, 1985, Ghost, 1986, and The Locked Room, 1986, right? So you have to remember that these three novels, which are a part of the New York Trilogy by Paul Auster, have been published in 1985, okay, and 1986. Consequently, it has since been collected into a single volume. The trilogy is a postmodern interpretation of detective and mystery fiction, exploring philosophical themes. See, the most important thing about Paul Auster's this neurotrilogy that it is a very, very important postmodern fiction, and we all know that postmodern is a very, very important topic which is being asked these days in NET exam. So the first question, so we can have a look again of the three novels in this trilogy: The City of Glass, published in 1985; Coast, 1986; The Lockdown, 1986. City of Glass. Okay, let's talk about City of Glass. The first story, City of Glass, features an author of detective fiction, as we have already told you. Who becomes a private investigator and descends into madness as he becomes embroiled in the investigation of a case. It explores layers of identity and reality. From Paul Auster, the writer of the novel, to the unnamed author who reports the events as reality. To Paul Auster, the writer, a character in the story. To Paul Auster, the detective, who may or may not exist in the novel. To Peter Stillman, the younger. To Peter Stillman, the elder. And finally, to Daniel Quinn, the protagonist. So see, it sounds somehow, very tricky, but this is how you have to remember it. City of Glass has an intertextual relationship with Michael De Cervantes, Don Quixote. Not only does the protagonist Daniel Quinn shares his initials with the knight. See, this Don Quixote is another very important topic. If you people remember, several questions have been asked from this Don Quixote. So Daniel Quinn shares his initials with the knight, but when Quinn finds Paul Auster, the writer, Auster is in the midst of writing an article about the authorship of Don Quixote. Auster calls article as imaginative reading, and in it he examines possible identities of the site Hamid Balanjali, the narrator of the Quixote. Let's move on to the third one, Ghost, 1986, by Paul Auster. The second story, Ghost, is about a private eye called Blue. See, here you have to remember certain colors, right, people, because people have been given the names of colors. So the second story, Ghost, is about a private eye called Blue, trained by Brown, who is investigating a man named Black on Orange Street. So we have got three men with the colors Blue, Brown, Black, and a street given the color Orange, right? For a client named White, right? So Blue writes written report to White, who in turn pays him for his work. Blue becomes frustrated and loses himself as he becomes immersed in the life of Black. Okay, The Locked Room. So The Locked Room is the story of a writer who lacks the creativity to produce fiction. Fanshawe, his childhood friend, has produced creative work, and when he disappears, the writer publishes his work and replaces him in his family. The title is a reference to a locked room mystery, a popular form of early detective fiction. Now, after Paul Auster, we have got Trilogy by Margaret Drabble, The Radiant Way, right? So her trilogy, Margaret Drabble was a British author, comprising The Radiant Way, 1987, A Natural Curiosity, 1989, and The Gates of Ivory, 1991. Follows the lives of three women who met at Cambridge during the 1950s. So you have to remember here, this trilogy by Margaret Drabble. I mean, this is based on basically women. It revolves around the lives of certain women. So this is what you people have to remember. In The Peppered Moth, 2000, Drabble detailed four generations of mothers and daughters in a Yorkshire family. Well, so the first novel in the trilogy by Margaret Drabble was published in the year 1987. Margaret Drabble was a British novelist, and she was known for providing social commentary and critique of 1980s Britain, right? So if you people read certain quotes of Margaret Drabble, so you'll get to know that, I mean, she was the one who always believed in highlighting the faults of the society for the betterment, right? By exploring the lives of three Cambridge educated women with careers as knowledge professionals, The three women are Lige Headland. Please remember these names. The three women are Lige Headland, a psychologist; Esther Brewer, a writer and lecturer on obscure historical artifacts; and Alex Bowen, who is teaching English literature to female prisoners. Right. So please remember Lige Headland, Esther Brewer, Alex Bowen. These are the three women we have got in the first novel, The Radiant Way, published in the year 1987 by Margaret Trevor. So next novel in this sequence is A Natural Curiosity, 1989 by Margaret Drabble. A Natural Curiosity is a 1989 novel. By the novel is an unintended sequel to Drabble's 1987 novel, The Radiant Way. So, right, so see, you, this is something which you need to remember, that it is unintended. So it was done unintentionally. So the it became the sequel of the previous novel, The Radiant Way, unintentionally, and it follows the lives of the three protagonist women first introduced in that novel. Right, you remember just now we have discussed about those three women. The novel continues Drabble's interest in exploring the contemporary experience of the British middle class through the eyes of women. So this is what you have to remember, that unlike the previous two trilogies, this is the novel, first of all, by a British author, Margaret Drabble. Secondly, it has got nothing, fiction, nothing, no mystery and all, but it's basically centers around the middle class life of women, right? Or you can say life of the middle class women in Britain. Now the third novel in the same sequence is The Gates of Ivory, 1991. It was published in the year 1991. So The Gates of Ivory, again I am repeating that this trilogy is basically by Margaret Drabble, right? The author has been authored by Margaret Drabble, a British novelist. Novel is the third in the series of novels following The Radiant Way and Natural Curiosity. The novel continues the stories of several middle-aged intellectuals introduced in the last two novels. The novel also introduces a new character, Stephen Cox, right? So we remember that in the first two novels, The Radiant Way and A Natural Curiosity, there are three ladies, right? Educated class, from middle class, educated class. But in this last novel, The Gates of Ivory, we have been introduced with another character whose name is Stephen Cox, who is loosely based on J.G. Farrell. So new trilogy is in the line. So friends, I hope this video will be somehow helpful for you. Well, I'm going to make another video on these, on the given trilogy. So I'll be making two videos for, and every video will be containing three trilogies, right? Three trilogies. So the six trilogies I'm having in the line, pipeline is The Foresight Saga by John Galsworthy, Jess Trilogy by Toni Morrison, The Bill Hodge Trilogy by Stephen King, Matt Adam Trilogy by Margaret Atwood, Wolf Hall Trilogy by Hilary Mantel, Ibis Trilogy by Amitabh Ghosh. So friends, you appreciate this video, or this video is somehow helpful for you. Thank you so much. If you really like the video, please hit the like button, share and subscribe button. Thank you so much. Have a good day.